In this video, we were trying to see how Cramer's rule will be helping us to solve a system of linear equations. The formulas are put on the corner, which is delta x over delta, y is delta y over delta, and z is delta z over delta. So let's see what are delta x, y, z, and delta itself. Let's take the easiest one, two equations, two unknowns as an example. In matrix form, you will be presented it as 1, 3, 3 minus 2, multiplied to a column matrix called XY, equal to the numbers on the right-hand side, 7 minus 1. So this is the matrix presentation. The meaning of delta will be talking about the determinant of this matrix, which is delta is determinant of 1, 3, 3 minus 2, so which gives you minus 2 minus 9, which is minus 11. So this is the meaning of delta. While the meaning of delta x will be, so we will be using this matrix as the basic, but we will change the numbers of 1, 3 by the column of 7 minus 1 when you want to find delta x. So that means it's 7 minus 1 here, keeping 3 minus 2 in the determinant. So it gives you minus 14 plus 3, which is minus 11. So similarly, now we can look at how we want to find the y. I put it in another color. Delta y would be, we replace the determinant of the numbers in determinants 3 minus 2 by 7 minus 1 over there. So that's why it's 7, oh, let's write properly, 7 minus 1, whereas the numbers 1, 3 are still using the 1 from the matrix itself. So that's why it's minus 1 minus 21, which is negative 22. So as a result, x will be delta x over delta, that means it's a 1, while y will be delta y over delta is a 2. So here comes the answer. Compared to using inverse matrix to solve a system of equations, you will find that Cramer's rule will be much, much easier, convenient, because it only requires to find the determinant. While in inverse, you need to deal with finding adjoint, transpose, determinants, etc. So that's why Cramer's rule will be much, much easier to use and to apply it when you want to solve an equation with a solution. Next, let's take a look on a question or a system of equations with three equations, three unknowns. So my habit will be I will start finding the determinant first, but on the other hand, I won't write the matrix form because it's very time consuming. Instead, I will do the determinant will be 2, 4 minus 3, 3 minus 8 and 6, 8 minus 2 and minus 9, and do it very carefully and obtain the answer, 294. So this is what we call delta, the determinant. Afterward, then we will start going to find what is x. X will be right horizontally here, so it's delta x over delta. So while delta x, you will be replacing the numbers 3, 1, 4 in the first column, because it's the column of x. While the other numbers, you will be following by 4, minus 8, minus 2, minus 3, 6, and minus 9, respectively. So now the denominator won't be that trouble, because I can write 294 directly. So again, do the calculation very, very carefully, and I obtain a 1. Normally, in the question, or maybe an exam, the questions are designed so that the answer won't be that ugly. So you expect that it may be just simply integers, positive or negative, or sometimes maybe it's very simple fraction, maybe something over 2, etc. So while for y, let's do it continuously. So once again, 294, I can directly put in the denominator. While delta y means that the column y will be changed to 3, 1, 4, whereas the other numbers you copy from the coefficients, 2, 3, 8, and minus 3, 6, minus 9, respectively. So afterward, again, do the calculation very, very carefully, and you obtain 1 over 2 finally. So that's what I said, simple fraction. 1 over 2 will be very simple enough to be accepted in the answer. And finally, we have EZ to be delta EZ over delta. So 294 at the bottom at first. Now for EZ, we change the column to 314, the last column. And then so the others will be copying coefficients. We have 2, 3, 8 for each column, 4 minus 8 minus 2, second column, and do it very carefully, you have 1 over 3. So that's how we apply Cramer's rule to find the solution. or in this question, they are X, Y, Z. And then last, so you draw the conclusion or a statement saying that X, Y, Z to be 1, half, and 1 over 3, respectively. So now you will definitely find that Cramer's rule will be a very big gift for you to solve a system of equations which has unique solutions.